This business owner has an answer for every complaint, but as we discovered, those answers rarely check out.
Why do you get your facts straight?
I don't. Apparently nobody gets their facts straight, according to you. Even people who filed suit against you.
This is Justin Pattison, the owner of Game Room Concepts in Overland Park. We're here to get answers for these people who say they never got what they paid for.
This guy just lies through his teeth. Pool table go right here. And
Charles Clough has been waiting for his $4,300 Olhausen pool table since April.
And they delivered a table that was not an Olhausen to begin with. And it was jet black, which was not what we ordered. And it was beat up and used.
He even showed us pictures of the chip wood. Clough wouldn't accept it and months later is still waiting for his table. So is Dorsey Swope, who was supposed to have her $5,000 pool table last May.
And that's when this nightmare started.
She's been told six times it's being delivered. The last time was 4th of July.
I was there all day. No call, no show.
That's why both Clough and Swope decided to join forces and pay a visit to Game Room Concepts on Metcalf while we waited outside.
Why do you think I'm here? Because the table didn't get delivered, you're right, and nobody called me.
An hour later, this guy, store manager Bill Waller, paid us a visit, telling us to get lost, but promising us the problems were solved, starting with Mr. Clough.
He's going to accept his table today.
The promised delivery time, 4 p.m. Clough told us a table was delivered, but it wasn't the table he'd ordered. He turned it down. As for Swope, she was told her pool table is at a warehouse near Prospect. She'd have to wait until the next day to pick it up.
So I feel like I'm just getting the runaround once again.
She was right. The table wasn't there. She still doesn't have it. Just another reason Game Room Concepts has an F rating with the Better Business Bureau and a slew of online complaints. Despite that, owner Justin Pattison made this remarkable claim.
But I mean, at the end of the day, it's very, very rare that I can even remember a case where somebody didn't get what they ordered or they weren't satisfied.
He must have forgotten about Greg Brockus.
They're terrible. I've been treated horribly.
He paid $4,000 for a shuffleboard game that was supposedly once owned by George Brett. Game Room Concepts even promised the former big league slugger would personally autograph it.
6 months later, I have no table, and they've got my money, and I've been lied to.
He sued and won, but has never seen a dime. Then there's Dan Fowler. Fowler also ended up in court over his shuffleboard game.
It's really wavy down here. Of course, we won. He appealed, lost the appeal, and he still owes us $1,500.
How about Dan Lieb? He also sued after he put a guitar lamp on consignment at Game Room Concepts, but was never paid. The day he was headed to court, Pattison finally gave him back the missing lamp.
Oh, it's just weird.
Of course, the man behind all that weirdness, Pattison, remains defiant as ever.
Before you show up like this, like, you got to get both sides of the story.
Well, that's what I'm here to do.
His side in a nutshell, everyone has their facts wrong. Except, of course, him. Pool table manufacturer Olhausen is so alarmed by what's happening at Pattison's store, it no longer will let him sell their tables. On the bright side, Olhausen is helping some of the customers solve their problems by giving them replacement tables. Unfortunately, Dorsey Swope's pool table wasn't made by Olhausen. However, Pattison did let her take a pinball machine from Game Room Concepts when he couldn't deliver her table. She says she's still out money. Fox 4 problem solver Linda Wager, working for you.